Argentina. Jesus Christ is coming again. Are you ready to meet him?
Metadão, qual é uma?
Are you called by your family name or you are called by the name of Jehovah?
Opa, metadão, qual é uma? Olha, esse pão, qual é uma?
You call yourself a Christian.
Opa, olha, meu Cristo, então.
The day that you hate the pastor preaching.
Porque tu lhe está uma família em
agora. You gave your life to Christ.
E aí, como vai ganhar Cristo?
That day.
Domagua.
You stop living the way you, your mommy gave birth to you. You began, you were now born in Christ.
And I said, but grandma, what you want to see a book of two and three to me?
Now you have a new identity.
Yes, I'm super boy like you.
Now, for example, if you knew me in the world,
but I'm a little bit in the world,
and I was a drunkard,
never in
the world, and I was an armed robber,
man, never in the world,
or I was a liar, or I was a 419,
or
let's say I was a, just give me some of the bad names.
Me now go for you.
And now I am now a Christian.
Now can you tell me that Christian?
The way you knew me.
Let me tell you now,
that I was in the past.
Let me never
hear. I am no longer like that.
You tell me that.
Are you listening to me?
Let me tell
you. So when you look at a man today,
yeah, that is from a
and you judge him,
yeah, I drop from a man.
When you see him today,
let me tell you, my God.
You judge him by what he looks today.
Yeah, I drop from a man. Let me go,
Deborah. And you see him tomorrow. You cannot stay with me and pray with me together.
Are
you listening to me? There are some people where they are praying. They are proud.
God,
you know something? The other day, is it God you are talking to? One day I was praying with some people. I was standing there and I was praying.
You thought the woman
there are some people. You can't pray with them. Because if you are not careful,
never go my
pull you down.
What did you
do? I'm telling you. They will pull you down.
What did you do?
You see my small girl.
When I'm praying with her,
the way I can climb.
Look at that,
that's one hill.
Young Vima.
By the time a woman and Jeffrey had me blew a hammer.
I think I've sorted the way I feel me
out. On one cover four times.
I have to go to the whole world.
It's it. The whole shadow, not who shed the wool, not quite a kitchen.
Never acquire the Vitukuma.
Oh, Papa, I won't. Not a dear grammar orca.
Never saw that you never go to come out
here.
Look at him.
provide for you. But
amen.
Are you listening to me?
Let's go, no man.
You see, there are some people the enemy just sends them to bring you down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the Bible says, if my people who are called by my name. Let me read it again. Are you here with me?
Yeah.
Lift up your right hand.
Yeah.
Say Jesus. Speak to me. Through your way. Let your way.
Let your way.
Bring understanding. Let your way. Open doors in my life. In the name of Jesus. This morning. Let my prayers be answered. In Jesus' name. By fire, by force. Amen.
Amen.
Now, we are reading 2 Chronicles 7:14.
Amen.
Amen.
And I want you to pay attention to the word of God. He said, if my people, which are called by my name, if my people, which are called by the name of God, God
is
saying that if my people that are called by my name, shall humble themselves, if they shall humble themselves and pray, it didn't say if they shall humble and go for prayers. When we talk about humility, humility is in the heart. Humility. Humility is not the way you talk. Humility is not the way you behave. Humility is not the way you how you behave towards when someone you are talking to someone, oh please, thank you. That is not humility. Humility is in the heart. And your way towards the things of life. That is what is called humility. Are you listening to me? Hello?
Hi.
Hello?
Hi.
Humility is from your heart. And the way you behave towards the things in life.
Amen.
Amen. And God is saying, and if my people shall humble themselves, and they will pray. Hello? And seek my face. My face. Now people no longer seek the face of God. They only seek the face of God when they have problems. When the marriage is not working, then they go to God, they say, oh God, I am before you. When the doctor tells them that this sickness is dangerous, oh Jesus. Father, I have humbled myself. Oh, Father, I am seeking your face and I am praying. Are you listening to me? He said, my people, not when you have a problem that you become a people of God. And shall turn from their wicked ways. What? Now, how can you be a people of God and still live in your wicked ways? Because when you become God's people, you need to follow God. Are you listening to me? That is why God gave the people of Israel the commandments to guide them. The commandments. It's the manual. It's the instruction. Are you listening to me? When you buy television set, there is a manual to operate it. When you become a child of God, the Bible is there to lead you. Are you listening to me? And God is saying, if my people shall humble, he said, then will I hear from heaven I will hear them from the heavens.
Yes.
And I will forgive their sins. And I will heal their land.
Yeah, you know,
God said that when you have turned from your wicked ways, there is a way that seems right to a man. And the Bible said that the end thereof is evil. Your ways will lead you to death. But the ways of God will only lead you to success. He said, I will forgive them their sins. When only they have turned, and they have hearkened to me, and they have seek my face, and they have prayed, he said, then will I heal them. I will hear from heaven, and I will heal the
land.
The enemies will plan evil against you, but you will continue to move forward. You will continue to move forward. You are listening that I will hear them from the heaven. And I will hear their
land.
May God hear you tonight. This morning, may God hear you. Now, verse 15, he said, Now my eyes shall open, and my ears attend unto thy prayer that is made in this place.
Amen.
God said, now my eyes will open to you. It means that God will seize you. Tell someone, God will seize you. Listen, when you start praying and you have turned from your wicked ways and you have humbled yourself and you have seek the face of God, there are some people, when they come to the house of God and they are praying, they want to look so nice. So when they are praying, then they are just doing themselves, oh Jesus, Father, you know, oh Jesus. Why should you come to the presence of God and you are doing gentility and praying so nicely? Hello? God said, I will see you. So you can look ugly when you are praying, but yet God will find you. Are you here with me? He said, now my eyes shall be opened and my ears attend unto thy prayer that is made in this place. God said, his eyes will open and his ears will attend to your prayer. He said, for now, have I trusted and sanctified this house, that my name may be here forever, and my eyes and my heart shall be there perpetually. Verse 17, and ask for thee, if thou shalt walk before me, as David thy father, my God. Do you know something? I want you, God is speaking to you. God is not speaking to Solomon here. Take Solomon's name out of that place and put your name there.
And
ask for you. Ask for me. If I shall walk with God, like the way the forefathers have walked. Hello? He said, and do according to all that I have commanded thee, and thou shalt observe my statutes and my judgment. Then will I establish the throne of thy kingdom, according as I have covenanted with David thy father, saying, there shall not fall thee a man to be a ruler in Israel. Can I hear somebody say amen?
Amen.
Put your hands together for the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Are you here?
Yeah.
Oh, are you here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Doctor,
it is only through prayer. That you can receive your miracle. Tell somebody it is through prayer. Tell somebody it is through prayer. It is through direction. Do you know that prayer is a hard work?
And
prayer is a hard work. There are some of you, when you alone, you are praying, you don't feel it.
Me amalo no mi aga mi agbera meteneo.
You always want to pray with somebody.
Ajina kokobe agbera kala made.
And the Bible has said it.
Eh, people are praying na ma.
We should always be meeting so that we will encourage ourselves.
Ever the way me pero taranya no no mi adeji pora mi adon.
Are you here with me?
Me happy kulima.
Hello.
Ah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Tonight we are going to pray.
Any
demon that has been assigned against us, we are going to speak against that demon. Are you here with me? Lift up your right hand. Say Jesus.
Say
Jesus.
Yes.
Any demon assigned against me, any powers, any occultic powers, are you here with me?
Are you
here with me?
Me
have
you put him out?
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lift up your right hand. We didn't finish with the preaching room. But we are doing this prayer exercise. Lift up your right hand. Say Jesus.
Yes.
I didn't hear you. Say Jesus.
Yes.
This morning.
Yes.
And the demon.
Yes.
Fighting against me the last
time.
In my life.
Yes.
When I am moving forward.
Yes.
Then they will orchestrate.
Yes.
They will work.
Yes.
To bring me backwards.
Yes.
This morning.
Yes.
By fire, by force.
Yes.
By fire, by force.
Yes.
Now this is our last prayer. Lift up your right hand.
Say Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Holy
Ghost. Any demon. In my family. My mother's house. My father's house.
My
father's house. Any demon. That they have showed me to.
What's that in there?
Mami water.
Mami water.
Any occult.
Any occult.
Any curse. Following me this morning by fire by force. This morning by fire by force. This morning. This morning by fire by force. That curse, let it be destroyed. Daniel chapter 3, verse 1 to 30. The Bible said, are you translating? He made an image, an idol.
Amen.
Are you listening to me? He made an idol. And he declared that everybody should worship that idol. Your enemies have declared something in your life. That you, when you reach this stage, you will go up and you come down. Your enemies have made a decree on your life. You see, some spirit and some power have already constructed and some they have assigned certain things ahead of you. You need to identify those things. They told the king Nebuchadnezzar. They said, we refuse to go down. They stood up and they fought. Are you listening to me? You must know who you are fighting with. So that you can win your battle. As you are standing there. Who are you fighting with? You are not fighting flesh and blood.
Hallelujah! You're the coming king. Jesus Christ is coming again. Are you ready to meet him? Come over.